And so this truth about the dignity of the human person in respect to every human person's right to life is why the church speaks so publicly and so insistently about certain moral matters that touch upon even political realities and public policies. So we're speaking about hot button issues that determine whether or not a society believes life is sacred and worthy of living, like the issues of euthanasia and assisted suicide, and the issue of abortion. Because in these public policies, a society is going to determine whether it actually believes life is sacred, no matter what. In other words, if you are a Catholic politician and you support pro-euthanasia policies or pro-abortion policies, that stance as a Catholic politician separates you from communion with the Catholic Church, and you should not present yourself for Holy Communion. It's that important. It's that foundational. Because the right to life is the foundation of every other right that we have. And because God is the author of life, and we are not the author of life. But this is not only encumbered upon Catholic politicians, this is also encumbered upon each of us as lay faithful, whether you're clergy and you sit in the sanctuary, or whether you're lay faithful and you sit in the pews on Sunday. The church also says this, that if you are a Catholic, and even if you are not a politician, if as a Catholic you use your voting power in order to bring about in society policies that directly usurp God's authority as author of all human life, that places you outside of communion with the Catholic Church, and you should not present yourself for Holy Communion. Now, some people would call that really mean and nasty. No, this is a really important truth that God says is foundational for what it means to be in communion with me, because Jesus is the one who came to give life. And it is not for us to decide whose life is worth living or not worth living.